Hi, I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE, host of theCUBE, and we're here at AT&T Fiber, Brian Sherabian, who runs the social media for the Giants. And if you know theCUBE, you know me, you know we love social. We love social business, we love social interactions, and best of all, mobile, cloud, and social, and big data all come together. So tell us, what a challenge it is. You have a huge fan base. They love the Wi-Fi here.
Right.
They're used to all the amenities on the digital side. Now you got to come out with the social. How do you do that? What's going on? Give us the lay of the land here.
You know, it's it is a challenge, but it's a fun challenge, and I think we're in a very unique and great opportunity here in San Francisco. Like you mentioned, the Wi-Fi gives us this huge advantage. Our fans are very social savvy. Many of them have iPhones or Android phones. They're taking a lot of pictures. They're posting on Instagram. They're posting on Twitter. And we try to foster and encourage that engagement with our fans day in and day out. The challenge is 162 game season, it's a long season, and there's a lot of content, but you're telling as we like to say, we're telling a season-long story, so all of it kind of blends together. So it's a really unique job, but, you know, look at this place. This is our office, so it's an awesome job to have.
It's a very social environment, of course,
yeah.
A lot of activities to talk about. So talk about the challenge of social in general, right? Because I see fans all using social. You guys have what we call the fat pipes here to upload. Your upload
fat
speeds are really fantastic.
Right.
We did a test before the stadium, 30 meg up on LTE, 40 on Wi-Fi. Certainly that changes, but good uploading for the fan population that are here. Is there a software approach? Where's the innovation comes from? Is there best practices? It's an iterative, it's evolving process. It's fairly new. I mean, it's only less than 10 years since the iPhone really hit the scene. So what have you learned and shared with the folks out there for best practice?
I think, again, you take something that is it's been lasting for a while. I mean, baseball and coming to the ballpark is an American pastime. It's a social experience, though. We come with our family and our friends. We take pictures, we share that experience. So now that we have social media,
real-time update.
Yeah.
This, we do whatever it takes to get the interviews here.
This is what it is.
This is what it is. This is the challenge at AT&T Park. Boy, what a tough life we have here. We got to let the field crew, sorry, you can't do your job. Game's got to be delayed. We're talking social media, more important stuff. Yeah, but seriously, so what are you guys doing in terms of apps? What's the philosophy of the social media? What's the DNA of your group?
It really is engagement. I mean, we want to, it's interesting that our motto is giant together, stronger together. We bring this community of our fans together, that it's all inclusive. And I think that's what we try to do in social media. We want our fans to be a part of that story. We want to share in that experience. It's a 162 game season. Some years you win the World Series and some years you don't. You don't know that until the very end, and you kind of come along. And one thing we found is that fans love to be a part of that. They love to see themselves on the scoreboard. They love to see their tweets favorited. They love to see behind-the-scenes photos. They love to feel like they are an insider with our organization. And that's, I think, where we bring social media to bring our fans closer.
One of the great things about social is the crowd can talk back and you have to listen.
Yeah.
So what are you guys doing on the listening side to foster better engagement, to give really good actionable insights and pleasures to your audience? And the fan experience certainly now takes on a whole nother dimension in the game, in the stadium. You have to listen, you have to respond. What do you guys do? How do you guys handle that?
I think we've done a fairly good job responding in real time on Twitter, using it as a customer service channel. But I think going deeper than that, this is a focus group for us. We're learning in real time what our fans think about the team, what do they think about the experience, on the micro level, what do they think about their particular seats, their experience at the ballpark. How can we learn from that? And we're more so than responding to everyone. I mean, we try to respond and engage with many fans, but even more importantly, we're listening to our fans. We're taking a lot of the data that we see, we're talking about it. Everything from how we display replays off of challenges, and are we doing that the right way? Is that, giving our fans the utmost experience? So essentially, our fans here give us feedback 365 days a year, and we're able to take that and elevate our business.
And certainly San Francisco, some of the most socially advanced fans technically. I mean, you got Twitter here, got Facebook, you got Google all in Silicon Valley, and the population of tech savvy. So the standards are pretty high. You feel a lot of pressure on that?
Yeah, I don't know if I feel pressure per se, but I think we definitely feel the bar is raised. And yeah, there is an experience, but it is baseball as well. I remember when we first built the ballpark in 2000, the overwhelming response of fans wanted to get away from the technology. At the time, you know, 2000 was a different time.
Yeah.
That's changed now that the iPhone really just changed people's, how they look at technology. So I think with all that being said, you know, technology adds to the experience. So, you know, we have a At the Ballpark app, which we're able to customize and make the ability for fans to customize for their experience at the park. So we're trying to use the technology out there to help our fans, everything from the minute they leave their house to the minute they're here. How can that help them experience this ballpark?
So tell me two things. The most coolest thing you've ever seen come out of the whole social initiative from a fan base, and two, the crowdsourcing dynamic.
Yeah.
What is the coolest thing you've seen come out of the crowdsourcing concept? Well, the fans are there. Probably some weird stuff, probably some great stuff. What is the coolest thing you've seen?
Well, I mean, I think that goes hand in hand. I think in 2012 when we were in the postseason and the whole Rally Zito movement, and it started, we were down 3-1 in St. Louis, and Barry Zito was pitching the next day, and a fan started a hashtag, a meme, Rally Zito, and it just kind of spread overnight to the point where it just kind of took over. And the Giants, you know, came back and won that game, launched them into the World Series and won the World Series, but it was really this engaged fan base that started that. It was almost, you know, as if one fan was clapping in the stands and the rest, it took fire.
Yeah.
Same thing happened on Twitter. And it was a really cool thing to see. And that was crowdsourced. And I think that's, you know, kind of the philosophy we have is that, you know, by no means are we controlling that conversation. We're part of that conversation, and we want to foster that conversation.
So you're saying that the fan experience in the crowdsourcing virtual space affected the team's performance, almost as if they were in the stands themselves.
See, I love it. You know, I didn't say that. I'd love to say. I wish I could say that.
No, but that's what happened. The fans rallied in a virtual stands.
In this world of saying that the baseball gods shined down on us, and that had a small part, absolutely. Why not? The fans helped us win the World Series.
Fans, if you're on social, you better get going because we need some offense. Let's see some offense on the Giants in some stretch.
We need 5 runs today. That would be helpful.
So what was the coolest thing you've seen on a tweet? What's the most epic tweet you've seen on the scoreboard?
Boy, you know, we see a lot of tweets on the scoreboard. I think the best tweet we ever saw, going back to that, and it was our tweet, but it wasn't our photo. It was, here's how it worked. The team was on a plane, and they weren't sure if they were going to St. Louis or if they're going or if they weren't going to Washington, D.C. or home, and they were watching the St. Louis-Washington Nationals game. And our traveling secretary sent me the picture, and I tweeted it out, and it just captured kind of this emotion of the team watching the game. And it just brought a lot of attention to, you know, to the fact that social media takes you to places you've never been before, on a charter plane, watching a team that looked like a bunch of little leaguers. So from the team side, I think we're able to get behind the scenes. We're able to get our players to kind of share a little bit about, you know, what they are privately, as much as, you know, they're willing to give. And our fans love that.
Yeah.
So we're always looking to kind of bring our fans into the front row, as they say.
That you capture those moments that are behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Now accessible.
Very nice.
Brian, thanks for joining us. I really appreciate you coming on the field and talking to us, SiliconANGLE and theCUBE. Thanks for all your support. And also, congratulations on a really badass social program you guys out here.
Oh,
really well done.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I think we can say badass, but it's not really
our show. You can say whatever you want. Yeah.
Social TV, social media, social interactions, this is the future, and now the fans are involved, the teams are listening, and certainly it's great for everyone. Thanks so much for coming on theCUBE. This is John Furrier live on the ground here at AT&T Park. We'll be right back. Thanks for watching.